So essentially what happens is that every time there's one really good product, people try to find what's the closest to that good product at a more affordable price. So if you click this video, you're probably trying to get contacts-like quality images, but at a much more affordable price. As you all may know, film camera has taken a crazy surge in the past few years. Not that it ever died at all, but it definitely went away from the scene. And someone who played a huge role in that in a weird way was Kendall Jenner. A couple years ago, she started posting pics on IG with her Contax T2 or T3, can't remember which one, but they took off and people started to say that those type of pictures made them feel like they were living in their memory. So film camera started to absolutely boom. Now, me being a photographer myself, getting into medium format, doing digital photography, I always thought it would be super important to just kind of have a quick grab and go 35 millimeter camera that I could always keep on me at all times. But I didn't want to sacrifice quality, but at the same time, I didn't want to pay $1 million to get a Contax or a Leica M6. A couple months ago, I was actually just browsing online, just looking at all sorts of different 35 millimeter cameras, trying to decide which one. Watching Valandis videos, watching Willem videos, just all sorts of things. And I actually, through some research, came across this camera right here. This camera is the Nikon L35AF. And I picked it up a couple months ago for around 150 something-ish. But I think the real question is this better than a Contax? Is this something that you can grab at a more affordable price but still get that same quality? So I'm gonna show you some of the photos that I've taken on it so far and give you my opinion on if it's actually worth the cost. So let's talk about the pros of having a camera like this. Number one, it's so small. You can literally grab it, put it in your pocket, take it around with you. The strap is actually really good. You know, hold it on a strap and just kind of keep it on you at all times, not having to worry about carrying a bunch of bulky equipment, but still knowing that you can get some really quality pictures right in the moment and not having a million different pieces of gear on you. Another thing that's really good about this camera is if I hand it over to someone, they can easily understand how to use it and to take a really good picture of you or a picture of you and your friends. And so it's just really, really user-friendly. The focusing on this is extremely, extremely good and super, super easy to follow. And it's also good if you're a street photographer because you can actually take a picture, hold your shutter, walk away, and then let it go, and it'll capture that picture that you had taken without the people even knowing, so you don't have to have that weird moment where they hear the shutter sound and they kind of look at you and then they're just like, yeah. Another thing about this camera is that it actually has a really good quality lens, and I think it does a really good job of capturing really good photos, and it also only really has one thing that you have to adjust, which is your ISO. And so usually, depending on whatever type of film that you put in, you kind of adjust the ISO as, you know, you're changing film. So if you're using 200 speed film, probably want to put it at 200. If you're using 400 speed film, put it at 400, and then you can go over or under a stop as you please. Another thing that I really enjoy about this camera is the actual flash. The flash is really good, and it kind of gives you that old 1990s paparazzi look when people would catch others in the most random moments or really just focusing on the subject, but giving you that feeling that you get when you're looking at like an old magazine picture or an old news article. The flash on this is really, really good, and I don't think it ruins the pictures like some flashes do in other cameras where it's just way too much and on some where it's just way too little. Pop in some film, change the ISO, and then just start shooting. I will say there's one thing about this camera that actually really bothers the absolute shit out of me. It's the battery holder, or whatever this is called right here. This pops open all the time, and I've seen people actually take some tape and put it on it, but I kind of get scared that the tape will kind of get scratchy and I'll have to just keep scratching it in. And eventually, if I want to sell this camera, I just want to leave it in as good of condition as I possibly can, and so I don't want to really, you know, put all of that on it. And so now we can ask ourselves, is this camera actually better than a Contax? And the answer to that is it depends on what you're shooting for. Can it actually compete and keep up with some of the quality that the Contax cameras can do? Yes, it can. But you know, the Contax cameras are super expensive because they have these Carl Zeiss lens on them, and which makes the camera a lot more expensive, but that also means they're getting a lot more quality. Don't get me wrong, the lens on these are really good, but Is it Carl Zeiss? Probably not. But still, sometimes with film, you kind of want that roughness, that edginess, that ability to make you feel like you were in the moment when you took that photo. It's just honestly indescribable. But a reason why I do think that this could actually be much better than the Contax is if you're actually on a budget. For what I paid for and for the quality that I'm getting with it, it honestly can't be beat. This is now probably my favorite camera that I own. Just because it's so light, it's so easy to just grab it and go and just take pictures of my friends. I'm huge on keeping memories and capturing moments, and I don't want to feel like I have to set up a bunch of equipment every time I do it. With my Mamiya, I have to kind of stop, make sure everyone's in frame, and just do this. With this, I can just literally pull it up to my eye, grab a photo, and then keep it moving. It literally takes 5 seconds. So I love that. And so the Contax is obviously able to do the same thing, but you can do that, but a lot cheaper. All in all, if you probably came to this video, you wanted to see if you can get Contax-like quality, but at a much more affordable price. And with this camera, I think you honestly can. Will you have to probably play with it a little bit to get really good? Definitely, but that's with everything. I haven't seen a lot of reviews on this camera, and it was something when I picked up, I was kind of looking all over YouTube, just trying to find other people who have used it, but I decided that I would just make one myself. I've really enjoyed using this camera so far. I've only shot a roll or two in it, but I plan on doing a lot more pictures with it. I think it's really, really nice, really light, really portable, doesn't make anyone feel awkward, and I think it's definitely worth the cost, even now at about 300 bucks. If you enjoyed this video or you feel like I left something out or I didn't mention something, please leave a comment down below. I do ask that you guys please leave a like on this video. It does a lot with helping me grow this channel as I am trying to get better and making more content. But until the next one, peace. You wanna be in my life, let's run away for the night. The things your man ain't gon' lie. Lo-fi, low vibes. Lo-fi, low vibes. Lo-fi, low vibes.